It is functioning normally, and that's really what's key. So we're talking about general economic conditions improving, and we're talking about the financial system being stable to be able to support that. And that's what's important with respect to what I'm telling you is going on. Looking at some of the key indicators that we look at for auto sales, we put together what we call a leading indicator of U.S. sales. So it takes account things such as employment levels, income growth, some of those interest rate spreads that we talked about. And the important point, the important message here is that indicator right now is at one of the best levels since the early 1980s. So not only are U.S. vehicle sales improving, recovering from the sharp downturn, we expect them to continue to improve. With respect to our indicator, the key point here is it leads both on the upside as well on the downside. And right now, it's telling us the conditions are healthy for the industry. And when you look at the level of production, the peak production in North America had been around 2,000. We went through the downturn. The important point here is because of these healthy conditions for the industry as a whole, we're actually expecting vehicle production next year in all of North America, Canada, U.S., and Mexico to actually surpass what we had seen down in 2000. So we're expecting peak vehicle production. And when you look at the plants that the industry have in place, their operating rates are now around 90-95%, and the operating rates will actually climb to record highs. So we just saw last week that Honda here in Canada announced that they were putting additional funding, close to $1 billion, in their Canadian plant, or Canadian plants up in Alliston. Ford had done something similar with their Oakville facilities the previous year, and that's because operating rates are getting very, very tight. So the point here is that when you're looking at the overall environment for this sector, it is very, very positive. For the overall economy, it's positive news as well. And aside from manufacturing, I heard this morning how the agricultural sector is very important to the Durham region as a whole. Well, when you look at Canadian exports, agriculture used to be about 7% of overall exports a decade ago. It's now up to about 11%. So agriculture and food industry as a whole is becoming increasingly more important, not only for Canada, it's also the same thing on a global basis. So this is food exports as a percent of the global total. Similar numbers, used to be about 7.5%. It's now at about 10%. And in part, it's because of the growing importance of the emerging countries. So countries such as Brazil, India, Russia, they're importing more food goods. And so as of 2004, these countries used to account about 6% of the overall global food imports. It's now up to 12%. So as they become more important, that number is only going to be trending higher. So in that sense, you're definitely positioned in one of the growing areas. So in general, just sort of to close off, the key point that I'm bringing is that economic growth is likely to continue to improve. Most of the leading indicators that I track are positive, are pointing to stronger growth, and that's the case in particular with respect to the auto sector. And you know, obviously, you're well positioned in the food sector as well. Thank you.